Daniel here to talk more settings. The first video was well received and there's more preference settings that I would change from the defaults to make the Cubase experience even better. Starting with all events, same value. I've loaded up Halley and Sonic. I've just selected a preset from Eagle and I'll record a few chords. Okay, let me expand the editor window at the bottom. The chord notes don't end at the exact same time as expected. I'll highlight the last chord, select all the notes, and if I drag left or right, all the note lengths become shorter or longer in a relative manner. So let's go to Edit, Preferences, under Editing, go to Tool Modifiers, Size Objects, and let's assign a key command to all events same value. I will just use Shift, click Assign and press OK. Now with the same notes highlighted, if I hold Shift, now all the note lengths at the end are the same. And I can do that for the start as well, which can be handy. The next setting is audio pre-record seconds. This time I will use the key command I have assigned to access the preferences window by pressing F2. And then I'll go to record audio and then change the seconds for audio pre-record. I like setting it to 60, which is the max. I'll press OK. And it's great for recovering any recorded material before you pressed the record button or if your system failed while recording multiple takes. Your initially recorded files will take up more disk space, but you can minimize them within the pull window. So let's say I select this event, for example, and use my assigned key command to find within the pull window by pressing Ctrl Shift and F. I can right click on the file and then click Minimize File. However, this operation will permanently change the selected audio file in the pool and can't be undone, so I wouldn't do this on a mix that I'm still working on. So I'll click Cancel, close the window. And now that I modified the audio pre-record second value, if I just start recording, and let me just solo this track, and I'll stop, I can move the event to the right and I'll drag from the left and the audio from the previous explanation is now accessible. Track follows event selection. We'll automatically select the corresponding track where an event is selected within the project window. So right now that's not happening. So if I go back to the preferences window, under editing, check track selection follows event selection. Press OK. Now if I select any event, the track is also selected. And if I hold Shift and select multiple events, multiple tracks are selected. And then I can perform actions like moving selected tracks to a new folder, for example. I'll undo that. Next up, show event volume curves always. As the name suggests, it shows event volume curves regardless of whether the event is selected. So by default, with any volume reduction changes made directly to an event, will only show when you hover on the event with your mouse, as so. So go to Preferences, Event Display, Audio, and enable Show Event Volume Curves Always. Press OK, and now the curve will always show, which I think is a must-have when making event-based editing decisions. This next setting will display the pointer position along with the name of the track and event in the project window. So let's open the preferences window under editing, tools, and click select tool, show extra info. And you can see next to the mouse, the name of the track followed by the position within the grid is visible and handy when you need to know the precise location of the pointer arrow over any area in a track. The last change here is use inserts when scrubbing. Scrubbing can make it easier to find clicks and recordings, so I've assigned key commands for the different shutter speeds. So when I press the less than symbol, it reverses at half speed. And pressing the greater than symbol and holding plays back at half speed. I also have a playback double speed key command set. So I've set Control Alt and Full Stop to play back at double speed. And Control Alt and Comma to reverse at double speed. So with a full mix while I'm scrubbing, the level does drop because by default insert effects are bypassed. So let's fix this by opening the Preferences window. Go to Transport, enable Use Inserts While Scrubbing, and I'll also set the Scrub Tool Volume to the max, as it's not beneficial to have playback level changes while scrubbing, in my opinion. Press OK. Now, when I'm playing around with the shutter speeds, the level is consistent. So that's 6 essential settings to change in Cubase. Let me know if you want a part 3 to this video. All in all, take care.